Hello ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to show you how to remote debug web pages on your mobile phone using Opera Dragonfly on your desktop. What you will need? You will need a copy of Opera 10 on the desktop, and you will need a mobile phone running Opera 10 mobile. For example, I've got a Nokia here, which is S60. They also both need to be on the same local network, and in advance you should get the local IP address of the desktop, so that's 192 dot something, or maybe 10 dot something, or something like that. You can get that by ifconfig or ipconfig from a terminal window. So, first of all, we want to fire up Dragonfly, which we do from the Opera menu Tools, Advanced, Developer Tools, and that loads up at the bottom of the page. Now, as it is, that's perfect for debugging local pages or any page that is visible in the desktop browser. But in this case, we want to debug on this little chappy. So we go to Settings, and we've got a remote debug option there, which we enable. And that's port 7001 by default. And it says it's waiting for a connection on that port. Okay, no problem. We'll go to Opera 10 Mobile and go to the URL opera:debug, OPERA:DEBUG, and that brings up this page here. Can you see that? And we go down, we enter the local IP address of the desktop, 192.168.0.3 in this case, the port number I've kept at 7001, and click connect. And in the background you may have seen a little message pops up. The protocol version of Opera does not match the one which Opera Dragonfly is using. Now at the moment we're sort of between protocol versions, so we need to download this compatible version. It does it in a couple of seconds. And another message comes up again, we're waiting for a connection on port 7001. So again, we just go to connect on the mobile phone. This is just until we get both protocols up to the same version. Connected, so we click OK again, and there we go. The connection is complete, so now what we do is we fire up the page we want to debug on the mobile browser. Now with Opera Mobile 10 we've got tabs, so I have open in another tab already a CSS showcase, a very simple page that I made earlier. Back to the desktop, we now want to specify that page in Opera Dragonfly, so at the right hand side we click the little page menu or the window menu, and we select the page that is open on the mobile. That's a CSS3 showcase demonstrating background clip and background origin. Now when we've selected that, we can choose something from the body. For example, if I select the header and then the H1 tag, it then shows it in blue on the mobile screen, indicating that that's the active area, and I can now change that text in the desktop. So I can change demonstrating to shmemonstrating. But maybe that's too small for you. Maybe you can't see it. So on the right hand side we have styles. CSS is shown there, and I can edit any of these. So the font size for H1 is 1.4, but I'm going to push that up to 2.4. Oh yeah. But that's not it. Oh no. I can make it 3.4. I'm on fire. So you can do anything and change any style down here. You can add new styles, so I could add a new one making it red. In fact, I might just do that. Let's change the color to red. And it's red! And then using the up and down arrow keys on the keyboard, on the desktop, I can cycle through a lot of the default colors just to see what looks coolest. And I think lime is definitely cool. So there you go, remote debugging, Opera 10 for the desktop, Opera Mobile 10 for the mobile, both available for free from opera.com.